الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم. Welcome to our weekly program Tafseer Thursday. Alhamdulillah, in the last few classes we discussed 11 verses from Surah Mulk. Today we are going to continue on from there. So let's start off with the recitation of the 5 verses we are going to read today. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير وأسروا قولكم أو اجهروا به إنه عليم بذات الصدور ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه وإليه النشور أأمنتم من في السماء أن يقصف بكم الأرض فإذا هي تمور. Starting off with the first verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. Indeed, those that fear the Lord for with the unseen, for them is the maghfirah, is the forgiveness, wa ajrun kabir, and the great reward. This verse is continuing on from the previous verses. In the previous verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the people of the hellfire. They will be asked that no warner came to you. You were doing all of these bad actions. No warner came to you that warned you not to do them. They will say, yes, a warner came to us, but unfortunately, we rejected him. We did not listen to him. We belied him. These warners can be in different aspects. They can be in the Quran. They can be the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam or the other Rasul. They can be in the aspect of your parents, in the aspect of your teachers, in the aspect of your siblings. They can be in different aspects. So no one warned you of the actions you were doing. And this is not only go to the kufr, that no one warned you about the kufr that you're doing, but any of the bad actions. In today's day, there even the Muslims are doing so many bad actions. There are people there to warn you. You might be young right now. It's hard for you to understand. You are liking what you're doing. You're going to the club, you're loving it. But your parents are warning you. Your teachers are warning you not to do these actions. These can ruin your life. Then those people that will go in the hellfire, they will be asked that no warner came to you. So those people, they would regret that they did not listen to their warner. So for them would be the azab. And then, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ, those who fear their Lord, they had the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the fear of God, even though they were doing the bad action before, but now they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they repent, they ask for tawbah, and they promise not to do those actions again. For them is the maghfirah. They would be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ, and they will get the great reward, which is Jannah. The next verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَسِرُّوا قَوْلَكُمْ أَوَجْهَرُوا بِهِ إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. And keep your opinion a secret or proclaim it. Allah, He is the knower of all the things that are in the hearts. So during the time when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in Mecca, the kuffar, they were saying things that would basically to mock Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam behind his back. And they did not want him to hear about it. But Jibreel alayhi salam used to bring all those information to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So then the kuffar, when they were talking to each other, they used to say that lower your voice, whisper, do not say it loudly, so that the Rabb Muhammad cannot hear you, so that the Lord of Muhammad does not hear you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the jawab, gives them the answer, that you can whisper all you want, you can talk slowly all you want, or even if you shout, you talk slowly or you shout, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can hear you. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can even hear what's in your hearts. He knows what's in your hearts. He knows what's in your chest. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues on with the next verse. أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقْ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Should he not know what he has created while he is subtile and all-knowing? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that has created us. So will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not know what he has, what we do, what we are even thinking, what we are saying? And now over here, in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, should he not know about his creation? And over here, it's a general creation. And now, the next verse is basically going to talk about the creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about the creation that he has created for us. The next verse is, وَالَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ ذَلُولًا فَامْشُوا فِي مَنَاكِبِهَا وَقُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِي وَإِلَيْهِ النُّشُورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has created the earth. The first obvious creation that we can see, that we can ponder upon. وَالَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ. He is the one who has created, who has placed for you the earth. ذَلُولًا. ذَلُولًا actually, in the literal meaning, it actually means a domesticated animal. In the old times, the people used to travel on donkeys and camels to get to places. So the earth is basically like a domesticated animal. And the meaning from this is that the earth, we know now in today's, after today's modern technology and science, is how fast the earth rotates and everything. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this earth in such a way that it's calm. A domesticated animal is calm. When you travel upon it, it's walking calmly. You can travel upon it. It's not a wild animal. If it's a wild animal, it would just start running and would basically drop you to the ground and start running. So the earth, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made as a calm animal. You can travel upon it and it would not drop you to the ground. فَمْشُوا فِيهِ مَنَاكِبِهَا وَقُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِي. So walk between its ends. Manakib actually means between the shoulders, the part between the two shoulders. But walk between its ends, وَقُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِي, and eat from its provision. وَإِلَيْهِ النُّشُورِ, and towards him is the resurrection. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this earth as a peaceful land for you. So the worrying that you have to do is for the resurrection, for how you will face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The worry is not for this earth. Now going on to the next verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ أَنْ يَقْصِفَ بِكُمُ الْأَرْضَ فَإِذَا هِيَ تَمُورُ. In the previous verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was saying that he has made the earth as a dhalul, as a domesticated animal. So you are not afraid that you will fall to the ground. But for those people that have taken the earth as granted and have taken the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as granted, for them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that don't take these things as granted. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided his blessing for you, but you have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And have you taken security from the world, one who controls the heavens? That he will not cause the earth to swallow you when, lo, it is convulsed? So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has power over everything. He has created the earth, and the earth is the dhalul for you. You are walking on this earth. But if you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has authority over you. He has authority over the earth, and he can command the earth to swallow you and take you in one bit. So this is the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And look over here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sometimes talking about the ni'mat and about the fear. So he is taking both of these things together, that you have to have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to disobey him. And you have to do the ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May he give us the tawfiq of remembering what we said. And May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq of remembering the verses from the Quran and to understanding what the message the Quran is giving us. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khayr khalqi Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Assalamu alaikum.